In cycle 5, two things will happen. One, this instruction will write its result, and two, I'll try to issue the next instruction if I can. We can do that in either order. Let's say that we do the issuing first this time. This is a subtract in ROB5, writing to R4. R1 and R5 are ROB4 and 3. So I write the value of 3 here and ROB4 here. And then what I do is I mark that register 4 is from now on going to be pointing to ROB5. Because that's where I put this instruction. I have issued this instruction in cycle 5. And with that, I have completed the issue of this instruction, but it is not ready to execute because it still has one of its operands is not available and we need to wait for it. Another thing again that happens in cycle 5 is that we need to take care of the writing of the result for the ROB3 instruction. So what happens is this instruction writes the result of 3 with a tag of ROB3. Now this 3 is really written here and the instruction is marked as done. Also, the value of 3 is broadcast under the name of ROB3 so that the reservation stations can try to capture it. So what's going to happen is there is a match here. This one is waiting for ROB3. It's going to capture a value of 3 and no longer waits for ROB3. So this is what happens in cycle 5 as far as broadcasting of this result is concerned. Note that the RAT and everything is not updated yet. That will happen at commit. So now in cycle 5, we have finished our issuing here. We have broadcast the result. We are ready to move on to cycle 6. Neither of these instructions is ready to actually dispatch in cycle 5. So nothing will begin executing in cycle 6 because both of them still wait for something else. So in cycle 6, what happens is, as far as issuing is concerned, we're going to try to issue this instruction. As far as execution is concerned, these two cannot still execute because they're still waiting for something. As far as writing of results is concerned, the instruction 3 has finished writing the result and has been marked as done. These two still have a while to go before they're going to write their results because we're in cycle 6. The next thing here is going to happen in cycle 13. So in cycle 6, pretty much the only thing that happens is these two instructions continue to execute and we try to issue an instruction. We're going to issue this one by grabbing a reservation station and a ROB entry. We're going to be writing to R1. We are now named ROB6. R4 and R2 are coming from ROB5 and ROB1. So neither of those is available yet. And then we're going to mark that R1 from now on is pointing to ROB6. So with this, we have issued this instruction. Now, we have written the result of this instruction. So technically, this instruction by itself could commit in cycle 6. However, remember that an instruction cannot commit until all previous instructions have committed. So although this instruction would commit in 6 if everything else was committed already, it will actually not commit until at least cycle 43 or 4 or 5. So pretty much this instruction sits here as done. Others can use its result, but it cannot really commit until we commit the instructions 1 and 2. So in cycle 6, this is all that happens. There is no commit here. And now we move to cycles 7, in which case we have nothing to issue anymore, so issuing will not be an issue anymore. We cannot execute anything until we see some results being broadcast. So really the next cycle when something interesting will happen is cycle 13, in which we will have another write of a result. So let's just kind of fast forward through to that.